Let's talk about ABS. So, after the Filloween episode on the InnoFill 3D ABS, I got a ton of comments, some questioning my sanity, essentially because I pointed out a flaw with ABS in general, which is that layer adhesion basically disappears if you don't use an actively heated build chamber or even just any kind of a closure at all. And I had deliberately made that choice because, let's face it, at least 99% of all printers out there don't have a fully enclosed build chamber, let alone one that has an active heater in there. In fact, none of the printers I own, and only one single machine capable of printing ABS that's ever been in this workshop, was enclosed, and that was the Cell Robox. So while Filloween is supposed to be a series about typical, real-world performance of these materials, and not lab-grade tests and perfect world conditions, almost every single material still has that same trade-off. Either you print cold, that is, with a lower hotend temperature, in a colder environment, or use a stronger part cooling fan, or you print hot and crank the temperature up so high that you end up with a solidly fused brick that looks nothing like the original part you wanted. Well, where you want your parts to end up on that scale is totally up to you, but I tried to test somewhere in the middle ground temperature-wise, where you get parts that remain mechanically accurate and usable, but still get good strength. But of course, that will vary depending on what the part you're printing is being used for. So I ran a few more tests on the InnoFill 3D Natural ABS. I bumped up the temperature to 240 degrees, as you all suggested, though I'd personally have lowered the temperature for all the curling I was already seeing. Then I re-ran the strength tests in open air, in an enclosed chamber, and in the enclosed chamber plus a part cooling fan at a fixed 20% setting. Now, the chamber I'm using here is just the shipping crate the Dynamo 3D 1 Pro came in, and with the printer's heated bed going and the cracks sealed off as good as I can, it reaches 32 to 35 degrees in there, which, as you'll see, already has quite an impact. If you don't want to commit to building a chamber around your 3D printer, you could also just grab a trash bag or two and plop that over your printer. That should already be enough to have it heat up to where ABS will work much, much better. Now, of course, this doesn't just apply to ABS. I've also A/B tested Rigid Inks ASA, these parts right here, and as you can see, this also profits greatly from that extra ambient temperature, and other filaments like HIPS, Tolman's 910, and PC ABS also benefit from an enclosure. So let's look at the strength numbers. As expected, the high temperature by itself, as well as when combined with the enclosure, make this ABS a great deal stronger, almost doubling the rating it got at the original 235 degrees in open air. What did surprise me was that adding a fan seemed to increase strength even more. It's just a tiny bit, but I'd assume that's only from the layers lining up better. And really, it should have been obvious, because print quality took a plunge with both the extra temperature and when adding an enclosure. At its worst, even the vertical walls are completely jagged and unusable. Yes, that is very much a temperature issue. Now, it could counteract that by increasing minimum layer time, but at the same time that will reduce layer adhesion, so really you're not gaining anything. So while strength was much better with the higher temperature and the enclosure added, again, it's a trade-off between quality and strength. And realistically, if you add all those countermeasures of using a part cooling fan, going slower, etc., because you're effectively printing too hot, that's going to put your prints very close to where you started out. It looks like the filament just has that heat limit of how hot and fast you're printing, how warm your ambient temperature is, and how much heat you're sucking back out with a fan. What I also think makes a huge difference in this, obviously, is the filament itself. In this case, I used InnoFill 3D's material to give it a second chance, but it seems like it's one of those, I don't want to say watery, but definitely higher flow and lower strength materials, which essentially means that between the time when it comes out of the nozzle and cools down, it is very liquid, it is very soft. The Sun ABS I have also performs extremely similarly there, with you either ending up with weak parts or temperature artifacts. Even Rigid Inks ASA still profits a lot from the enclosed chamber, but it has much less apparent artifact from it. And particularly ABS blends can perform significantly better or worse than others, as we've seen, for example, with the Rec ABS. So, should you be using an enclosed chamber for ABS and similar filaments? Yeah, I'd say it's a good idea to have one, even and especially for the better filaments. And To be honest, unless you're living at the equator with no air conditioning, I'd heavily advise against using ABS without an enclosure. It's not just for how your parts will turn out, but it's also about health and safety, as ABS is one of the materials with a higher particle count, and an enclosure of any kind can help keep those fumes constrained. Performance-wise, I'll just repeat it again, even though I know the comments will disagree, but for normal users that don't need that last bit of temperature stability and don't vapor smooth everything they print, copolyesters, aka PET, PETG, are just a much better choice. And even for mechanical applications that involve a bit of heat, PETG is a great option. It's tough, it's reasonably temperature resistant, and so much easier to print well. Point in case, I printed the spindle motor holder from a Mendelmax 3 CNC conversion from Ultimaker CPE and thus filament PETG, and it's holding up perfectly. Now, does that mean ABS is universally a bad material and you shouldn't use it at all? No. It has its uses, but I believe that for many jobs there are just better and more consistent alternatives out there. Over the years, I've not encountered a bad copolyester yet, but I've come across many ABS filaments that didn't perform as expected. So, what do you think? Have you made similar experiences yet? Are you running ABS on a daily basis as your main material? I'd really like to know in the comments below. Either way, I hope this video is helpful to you. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing to the channel, and because YouTube is being sort of weird about it, remember to also click that bell or you might end up missing some videos altogether. If you want to support this channel with a spare dollar or two, head over to Patreon and get access to the monthly Q&A hangouts and more. That's it for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.